Hello, and welcome to designing a flyback DC to DC converter. In this video, you will get an overview on the basic non-isolated topologies. We will derive some topologies from the inverting buck boost converter and give a short guide for when using which topology. My name is Brigitte Hauke. I'm boost and buck boost controller application manager in Texas Instruments. This video is the start of a video series which will concentrate on the flyback converter design and give some guidance for practical issues. So let's start with some topology basics. Here you can see the schematic of a buck converter, also called step-down converter. It consists of three main components: the transistor, the diode, and the inductor. The input voltage is always bigger than the output voltage. Let's have a look on the boost converter. The boost converter uses the same three components: transistor, diode, inductor. The input voltage here is always smaller than the output voltage. And the third basic topology is the inverting buck boost converter. It uses exactly the same components: transistor, diode, and inductor. But here the advantage is that the output voltage can be bigger or smaller than the input voltage. The only difference to the other two basic topologies is that the output voltage is negative compared to the input voltage. On this slide, you can see the duty cycle calculation for a buck boost converter. And from that, you can see that the input voltage can be bigger or smaller or equal than the output voltage. So if the duty cycle is 0.5, the input voltage and the output voltage are equal. If the duty cycle is smaller than 0.5, the input voltage is bigger than the output voltage, and if the duty cycle is bigger than 0.5, the input voltage is smaller than the output voltage. From the basic buck boost topology, we can derive a lot of different new topologies. For example, SEPIC, CHUCK, SETA, or flyback. SEPIC and flyback are marked in blue because these are the ones that are used most often. Flyback especially for cost reasons or if isolation is needed, and SEPIC for EMI reasons. Let me show you two more non-inverting buck boost topologies, the so-called two-switch buck boost or four-switch buck boost. The difference between these two is the two-switch buck boost is using two main power switches and the rectifiers are diodes. For the four-switch buck boost, all four power switches are transistors. But which topology to select? This is a short guide based on power and cost. If your application has an output power of 50 to 100 watt, a good solution is either a flyback or a SEPIC converter. For higher power, up to maybe 200-250 watts, you might have a look on the two-switch buck boost converter. The four-switch buck boost converter can be used up to 300 and 350 watts. These numbers show you component numbers from Texas Instruments, which can control this type of topology. As we recommend SEPIC or flyback for lower power applications, let's have a more detailed look on these topologies. This is the basic schematic of a flyback converter. It is redrawn with the ground on the top for an easier comparison to the SEPIC. Here you can see exactly the same schematic. The only difference is a coupling capacitor from the input to the output, and hence now you have a SEPIC converter. So flyback and SEPIC have a very similar schematic and are recommended for similar applications. This table shall give you an overview on when to use which type of converter. For example, in general, the flyback is very well understood. The advantage of the SEPIC is that it can support lower EMI and it can support lower profile, especially when using separate inductors instead of coupled inductors. So select a flyback for lower cost, multiple outputs, wide input voltage range, or if you need the isolated output. This video gave an overview of the topology to select if the output voltage is in the middle of the input voltage range. Further videos will discuss the flyback converter more in details. You can find further information, for example, in the E2E forum, or ask your question there. A lot of details can be found on the product folder. You find flyback EVMs and user's guide, Excel design calculators, and a lot more application and collateral. In addition, reference designs are available for different topologies. Especially, you can find a lot of reference designs on flyback converters. Thank you for listening.